election, ladies and gentlemen, has seen it all. An alleged assault on the chief minister, an attack on the convoy of the BJP president, mass defections from one party to another, petty mudslinging, an EVM row, and a campaign fiercer than ever. The poll blitzkrieg became even more intense today with the Prime Minister launching a fresh salvo at his political opponent in the state, Mamata Banerjee, the Chief Minister of Bengal. Prime Minister Narendra Modi called out the Chief Minister's selective secularism in a scathing attack at a poll rally in North Bengal. What happened at this rally in Cooch Behar and what prompted it? Take a look at this report.
Even as the third phase of voting was underway in Bengal, campaigning for the remaining five phases turning feverish. Cooch Behar witnessing the launch of BJP's latest offensive. Prime Minister Modi taking a direct swipe at Mamata Banerjee, accusing Didi of blatantly playing the minority card. Modi warning Mamata that her appeal for a collective vote was past its sell-by date.
अभी हाल ही में आपने कहा कि सभी मुसलमान एक हो जाओ, वोट बटने मत दो। दीदी, आप ये कह रही है, इसका मतलब है कि आपको यकीन हो गया है कि मुस्लिम वोट बैंक की आपकी जो ताकत आप मानती थी, वो मुस्लिम वोट बैंक भी आपके हाथ से निकल गया है। आप वैसे तो चुनाव आयोग को गालियां देती रहती हैं, सुबह शाम एक ही बात करती रहती है, लेकिन जो बात आप बोल रही है, अगर हमने कहा होता कि सारे हिंदू एकजुट हो जाओ, बीजेपी को वोट दो, तो दीदी ये इलेक्शन कमीशन हमें 8-10 नोटिस भेज देता। प्रधानमंत्री को भी नोटिस आती, अध्यक्ष को भी आती, उम्मीदवार को भी आती। अरे इतना ही नहीं, सारे अखबार देश के पहले पेज पर भरे पड़े होते और दुनिया भर के एडिटोरियल लिख करके हमारे बाल नोच लिए होते।
The trigger for this sermon was Mamata's campaign pitch last week, where she urged Muslims to not fall for the likes of OVC and instead put their collective faith in the Trinamool Congress.
মাথা ঠান্ডা করে কাজ করবেন। হায়দ্রাবাদ থেকে একটা বিজেপির গাই এসেছে এবং ওইটা টাকা নিয়েছে বিজেপির থেকে, এবং সেটা ফুলফুরা শরীফের কেউ নয়, ওদের একটা বাচাল ছেলে আছে, সেই ছেলেটাকে নিয়ে টাকা দিয়ে সংখ্যালঘুদের ভোট ভাগ করবার চেষ্টা করছে। একটা ভোটও সংখ্যালঘু ভাগ করবেন না, তপশিলীরা ভাগ করবেন না, আদিবাসীরা ভাগ করবেন না, সাধারণ মানুষ ভাগ করবেন না। যতই ভয় দেখাক, গিয়ে কুরকুর করে বলবে, ওরে ওরা তো মুসলমান, তুই তো হিন্দু, ভোটটা দিবি না। তো মমতা ব্যানার্জি কি হিন্দু না মুসলমান? এই করে করে আমার 200 বেশি চাই, 200 কম হলে ওরা গদ্দারদের কিনে নেবে, এই গদ্দারদের টাকা দিয়ে কিনে নিয়েছে।
But it's resulted in Mamata's opponents lashing out at her open call to Muslims to align behind her. They are crying out at what they call Mamata's secular hypocrisy and double standards. Maybe the prospect of losing a captive vote bank is driving Mamata's rhetoric. Its immediate fallout may not be to her liking. An energized BJP accusing her of duplicity on her secular principles. With Tamal and Shreshi in Bengal, Poonam Burde for Times Now.
Here's why the BJP believes that Mamata's secularism is selective. Here are a few events that have armed the BJP's tirade against Mamata Banerjee. Take for instance Netaji's birth anniversary event in January this year, where Mamata Banerjee walked off the dais in a huff after being greeted by Jai Shri Ram chants. Then in March, a member of parliament from her party, Mohua Moitra, kicked off a storm when she said that it was better to be from the Rohingya community than from the Chotiwala Rakshas clan. The West Bengal Chief Minister in Bishnupur last year claimed that Jai Shri Ram chant belongs to the BJP and it is being forced upon the people of Bengal. Then in May 2019, Mamata Banerjee also got irked by the Jai Shri Ram chants, and at least 7 people were arrested for raising these slogans at Bhatpara. And not just that, Mamata Banerjee and her nephew also has regularly objected to the slogan of Jai Shri Ram, even going on to call it a TRP garnering tactic. And that, ladies and gentlemen, brings me to the legitimate question tonight. If the TMC claims Jai Shri Ram to be a communal cry, then can Mamata's appeasement of a particular community be called secular? That's the question and the debate. Modi versus Mamata Muslim card. That's the debate on the other side.
You're watching the News Hour at 9. Debate number 1 on Times Now. Super Prime Time.
Joining me tonight, Dr. Nikhil Prasoon, spokesperson of the BJP, Dr. Anand Ranganathan, author, Subhrashtra, author, Anirban Banerjee, political analyst, Ghanshyam Tiwari, national spokesperson of the Samajwadi Party. But my first question goes to Mr. Riju Datta. And Mr. Riju Datta, I want to ask you, why is Mamata Banerjee's report card on secularism just so checkered? She says secularism means that people should not come out and begin to make a official function where Jai Shri Ram is chanted. This is what she said in January at the Netaji function that was being held in Kolkata. Then how come La Ilahi Illallah, that is a completely secular cry that has been given? Why are Chotiwala Rakshases being singled out by the Trinamool Congress leaders? I want to ask you, is Jai Shri Ram merely a TRP statement as stated by Mr. Abhishek Banerjee? What is your position on it?
Mavika ji, I just want to categorically say that Jai Shri Ram, from bringing a very warm greeting in this country, BJP has turned into a political slogan, a bullying tagline, and you know it is used now to even demean the authority of a woman. So let's not get into that. But what I want to say is that if somebody is pointing a finger at Mamata Banerjee being communal, then I want to ask, when the Prime Minister, from the chair of the Prime Minister, said, "Inke pehnaave se pata chalta hai kisne aag lagaya hai," does he have the moral authority to talk about polarization? When BJP tied up with CDC in Jammu and Kashmir, which are completely anti-ally, for their own electoral gain, was it not polarization? When their founding father went back with the Muslim League during the independence, what was that? That was not polarization, but the electoral gain. Now, who is Faizullah, who was given a ticket? It was later proved that he went to Pakistan for anti-national training. When was that there? When was that BJP moral high ground? So our holier-than-thou Prime Minister should understand that we know what your appeasement tactics is. Even if you are not saying it, your blue-eyed boys are following it, calling people Bangladeshis and Pakistanis left, right and center. You can make some people fool some amount of time. You cannot make everyone fool all the time. And Bengal will be BJP's Waterloo.
Well, let me get in Dr. Anand Ranganathan. Dr. Anand Ranganathan, I think somewhere the lines between polarization versus secularism have got completely blurred tonight. You know, is polarization equal to secularism or communalism? Is polarization and secularism used as interchangeable words? Because Riju Datta is saying that the BJP is polarizing, and Mamata Banerjee's report card, her record on secularism, cannot be compared to the BJP. Respond to Riju Datta.
No, good evening, Navika. Let me tell you the fact and the truth. And the fact is that the most communal people in this country are the ones who declare themselves as the most secular. That's the bare fact. And I put Richuda in very high regard. But if you remember on your show, Navika, when I cornered him maybe a week ago, I think it was, or 2 weeks ago, as to why was it that Didi, gave 30,000 imams a salary of 2,000 per month and did not give an equivalent salary to any Hindu priest. He got so flustered that he started talking of Hindu imams, whatever that means. So maybe, I don't know, maybe he's still as flustered and he's going to call Didi as Huslim or Mindu. But the fact of the matter is, Rijuda, again, when I cornered him yet once more time, and I asked him a point blank question as to why is it when he says, according to him, that there is nothing wrong in us working for the Muslim community. I asked him with data, according to the latest periodic labor force survey that no one else gave. Only, why is it that only 13% Muslims have regular salary jobs in Bengal? The figure for India is 22.1%. Why is it that 35% of Bengali Muslims work as casual laborers? The figure of India is 24%. I asked him, why is it that Muslims in Bengal earn 27 to 40% lower than Muslims in the rest of India? Whereas Muslims make up 30% of Bengal population, why is it that only 7% of Muslims are university and college teachers? And if you remove the madrasa and the Muslim university teachers, the figure is even lower. You remember I asked him that. And what was his reasoning? What was his excuse? Oh, but we have only been ruling for the last 10 years. You ask this question to the people who have ruled Bengal for the last 34 years before us. So, you know, when you are exposed to such limits, Rijudatta, please don't mind. As I said, I admire your politeness and I sometimes wonder why you are in TMC. But the fact remains that you've been hopelessly cornered on this. You must accept that you are not secular, you are actually communal, and you are appeasing like nobody's business.
Well, Rijudatta, the question is, Mamata Banerjee says, don't vote Asaduddin Owaisi, don't vote... there is the ISF, the Furfura Sharif Imam. Don't vote any of these parties because I'm going to be the lone person who's going to look after your interests. And then she says, BJP comes here, gives money, goes away, which clearly shows that they have done nothing for anybody. I want to ask you, Rijudatta, you know, what if the BJP from the dais had said, Sare 70% Hindu, sirf BJP ke liye vote karo. Wouldn't there have been a hue and cry? Why are you calling the statement made by Mamata Banerjee as something that is responsible? Let's face it, it's not secular. So forget, you can at least be truthful and say secularism takes a back seat when there are elections on. When you say that, at least we will respect you.
Navika ji, first of all, give me 10 seconds to answer my dear doctor. You know, after last time he told me this, I went and checked the periodic labor survey in 2018-2019. And in that survey, 62.7% Muslims are self-employed in West Bengal, which is higher compared to India. And when he mentioned the basic income and, you know, the other things, the All India Survey of Higher Education, which even my dear doctor followed, which said 7.8% in 2019, but it risen from 2.3% in 10 and 11. The 52% self-employment rose from 34% in 2010 and 11. You have to understand the left regime decimated the infrastructure of West Bengal. They decimated the educational structure of West Bengal. They even opposed installing computers in our schools. From there we have come. We have a long way to go. Yes, we have a long way to go to empower the
people. But when it comes to Prime Minister Modi, you want him to have solved all the problems of India over the last, less than 7 years. How come 10 years are too short a time for you, Dr. Nikhil Prasoon? You know, Riju Datta says 10 years not enough for Mamata Banerjee to do, and he's reading out 52% Muslims are self-employed. Well, self-employed is another word, to say that they didn't get jobs. You think they're making more money when they're self-employed than if they had been doing jobs? Do you think the support system that comes through Ayushman Bharat, etc., has been kept away from all of these? How many of these 52% Muslims that you're talking about who are self-employed are above the poverty line? You know, isn't this also a statistic, Nikhil Prasoon, that should be looked at very closely?
Well,
good evening. As I have always maintained that this election happens to be an inimitable election in the history of our country, simply because the politics of pseudo-secularism and all these things are going to be done away with. because the political climate of our country is on the verge of a change. This parivartan is going to sweep the whole country as well. I would like to mention certain examples. For example, the example that our respected Chief Minister, the utterances of ours. Number one, je gaita doodh de tar lathiyo khete hai. This is one. Number two, I will go to iftar parties 110 times. Number three, so far as this Congress is concerned, Congress, what did the Congress party say? Congress takes great pride in maintaining that Congress is a Muslim party by Rahul Gandhi. Now, what did our former Prime Minister say? That Congress, the minorities have got the first share in the national resources. They were in a spree of branding Lingayats to be a separate religion. Now, these are certain examples based on which it can safely be construed that Congress is more communal than, and that these TMC in the opposition parties and the flock thereof, they are more communal than others. Because in the last 70 odd years, they have done nothing for the minorities. In fact, if it is analyzed microscopically, then our Honorable Prime Minister, with his flagship programs, which counts more than 120 of them, almost each and every program have touched the life of the minorities more than others. So far as this data is concerned, what does this data say? Those who are self-employed, they are almost unemployed. The average salaried income is 13,000 in the whole country, and it comes out to be less than 9,000 for the people, for the minorities in West Bengal. 22% of the minorities are in salaried class, but in West Bengal it constitutes around 22% only. The average salary of those who are casually employed happens to be around 6,000 in West Bengal, whereas it is to the tune of 9,000 in the whole country. So they have cheated the minorities as well. They have tried to play some kind of a symbolism so far as the minority vote bank is concerned, but now they have exposed themselves, and now they are on the verge of losing their minorities.
That's the point.
This vote bank
that's
as well.
The that's point. Ghanshyam Tiwari, you're very good with facts and figures. This. And I want to ask you, Mr. Ghanshyam Tiwari, is lip service equal to secularism certificates? Or do you think there is performance that has to be looked at? There are numbers that have been read out by Dr. Anand Ranganathan and also Dr. Nikhil Prasoon. But we will go by lip service, and lip service that happens in election rallies is completely different from what the facts on the ground are. And therefore, it's all very well for political leaders to come out and say that they will support the minorities. Very good. But in elections, to say you should vote as a bloc, I'm the only one who deserves it, the others have let you down, and therefore don't even vote for Abbas Siddiqui, don't vote for Asaduddin Owaisi, don't vote for the BJP because I've done a lot. Look at what she's done. Look at the Congress's record and look at the Trinamool's record.
Navika ji, today is a big day in our democracy. More than 150,000 polling stations spread across 475 assembly constituencies, 5 states, roughly 10 crore target voters engaged in the process of voting. What did they vote on? Did they vote on the daily Hindu agenda that is propagated by the Prime Minister? It reminds me of the story of dog ate my report card, and the entire community starts discussing the dog, not the report card. The Prime Minister does not discuss the fact that there is a Rafael scam where the French media is saying that Chokidar chor hai. It doesn't discuss the fact that the Supreme Court is saying that where is the CBI, full-time CBI director. It doesn't discuss the fact that under his nose, we have an internal security matter where 22 of our brave hearts are killed, martyred, and more abducted. The Prime Minister's report card is eaten away by the dog of communal politics, and the Prime Minister is carrying a dog whistle because he wants the nation to only discuss that communal politics. Nothing else. He has nothing to offer. COVID is rising across the country. The numbers are going through the roof. Every one of your viewers watching this is right now scared because they don't know what is happening to vaccines. They don't know whether under 45 vaccines will be given or not. The AIIMS director is saying one thing. The government is not saying anything. They are quoting the wrong WHO data to say why the vaccine should be denied. So this is a classic case where the Prime Minister has no agenda, no work. no responsibility. And he knows that whatever he says will make the national headlines, and we'll start discussing the dog, we'll not discuss the report card. Let's discuss the report card. Let BJP come and defend that why
Subrashaji, that's a scathing attack coming in from Ghanshyam Tiwari. But he talks about the Prime Minister singularly talking about issues that do not concern people. Is Ms. Mamata Banerjee discussing something else? When she goes to 19 temples in a single day, when she begins to read the Chandi part, when she begins to read the Durga part, is she actually discussing development? Is she talking about people, their livelihoods? What is she talking about? You know, it's very easy for the opposition to point fingers at the Prime Minister. But do you think, Subhrashtraji, Ghanshyam Tiwari is only seeing at one side of the coin and not the other?
Navika ji, in fact, this question was supposed to be asked to, perhaps Ghanshyam ji would have been able to answer this question better because he represents the opposition voice. But, you very rightly said that a single-handed attack is being made on the Prime Minister. But unfortunately, Bengal elections have not been about development at all. All the concerns that Ghanshyam ji raised, none of them made up even 10% of what Mamata Banerjee spoke about. And apparently, Mamata Samajwadi Party's star campaigner, Jaya Bachchan, was in Bengal discussing all these things. So I don't understand why is the opposition divided in its own narrative. Now, coming to a very moot question that, all of us have been discussing so far in this debate, it's very important to understand that something as tragic as the death of our CRPF jawans is making, into a primetime discussion. The fact is forgotten that our Home Minister actually ran to Chhattisgarh to have a conversation with the jawans and not only sharing that picture of the Home Minister sharing a meal with the jawans is a symbolic picture. It's about a fact that there is a Home Minister who has actually gone to look at situation on ground zero. But where is Mr. Baghel? Where is the rest of the Congress? Forget about anybody else. Let me ask Ghanshyam ji, he's a good friend. Where is Akhilesh Yadav in this entire thing? Akhilesh Yadav has nothing to do with Bengal or any, I'm sure there have been jawans from UP as well who were martyred, defending in Sukma. Why has Akhilesh Yadav not gone there? Why is the current Chief Minister of Chhattisgarh not around? Where is Rahul Gandhi? Somebody who keeps, who prides himself on the fact that he's a global ambassador for Indian-ness and Indian values. Where is he? The point of the matter is, Navika ji, that the opposition is so divided. Is so divided in not just the issues it raises, but how it raises the issues, that there's nothing much that can be communicated with the opposition. And which is why he made a very interesting observation, Ghanshyam ji, that we celebrated democracy around 1 lakh booths today. And when the same celebratory note would, celebrate BJP, BJP's victory, then these are the very same people who will come back at EVMs. So I really don't understand, as somebody who is not part of electoral politics in any which way, I'm not a member of any political party. I don't understand where the opposition is headed with this narrative.
Absolutely. And Anirban Banerjee, I want to ask you, when EVMs are found in the house of a Trinamool leader, then it isn't an issue for primetime debates. Then there is no problem. We should not discuss it. We will discuss democracy and the festival of democracy, the dance of democracy. But if it was found in a car where repoll was ordered, look at the way the opposition was up in arms. I want to ask you whether it's secularism versus communal labels that you have given people, whether it is democracy versus, central Hitler-like rule, or whether it is institutions that carry out and in any institutional and in any kind of election where elections are at such a large scale, a few things go out of place here or there. Why are motives attributed? Why should motives not be attributed, as Subhrashtraji says, to all those leaders who have not found time to go to Chhattisgarh and mourn the death of our martyrdom of our 22 soldiers? If it had been a BJP-ruled state, they would have all wanted to come. While I don't want to make politics over this, the question is, politics is created by the opposition itself on every single issue, including secular and communal labels.
Well, we always knew that the BJP is a party of outsiders who do not have any clue about the culture or history of Bengal. But we are also finding that they do not understand the language of Bangla. I mean, if you minutely, not even minutely, even casually hear the statement of the chief minister, she was not referring to just the Muslims. She was referring to many people, the people in general. It was so amply clear. Then is it a problem in understanding the language of Bangla for the BJP leaders or the Prime Minister? Or was it that the Prime Minister actually has nothing more to speak about but religion, communalism and communal divide as a whole? Where is the report card of the Union government in the last 7 years? There's a report card of the West Bengal government of the last 10 years. Where is the report card of the Prime Minister himself? Who is the chief ministerial face of the BJP? No one. The BJP is fighting with the plank of the Prime Minister in West Bengal. Therefore, we demand that the Prime Minister publish his own report.
Subhrashtraji is raising her hand. Subhrashtraji, Anirban says that Mamata Banerjee was not talking about Muslims at all. She was talking about all the people. We don't understand Bangla, or we don't understand her statement. What is it that Anirban hasn't understood? Because I think the whole country saw this.
Absolutely. I think Anirban claims to be the sole authority on Bangla and understanding the linguistics and semantics of that language. So in the benefit of interest, Anirban, I'm not yet done. Anirban, I heard you patiently. Have the patience to hear me out as well. He says that the Prime Minister has not given a report card for the last 7 years. Perhaps he has forgotten that we are not in a fascist regime. We had elections in 2019, and the people of this country gave a resounding majority to the BJP once again and entrusted their faith in the Prime Minister. So, Mr. Anirban, we need to frame your arguments well. Hold on, sir. Bengal has voted. Anirban, why are you so rattled here? You guys just voted. Allow me 20 seconds to speak.
I am not rattled.
Can you please repeat what Mamata Banerjee said in Bangla for the benefit of the viewers? Navikaji, can you please play that clip?
I am fed up with the BJP outsider leaders.
As to what that lady had to say, let the country decipher if it was a message for Muslims.
Dr. Anand Ranganathan, Anirban Banerjee has raised a new issue. He says Mamata Banerjee never called out to the Muslims. This is a figment of our imagination. Were you imagining Dr. Anand Ranganathan?
No, Anirban Da is absolutely right that Mamata Di actually meant all Hindus, because Anirban Da is a closet Sanghi, is an RSS person who thinks that all Muslims have Hindu ancestry. So what he means to say is that when she was saying that all Muslims should come together, sir, she was acknowledging that all the Muslims have Hindu ancestry. But can I come back to...
Manush to you. It is called general people.
No, but first of all...
Amra Shabai Bangla Kotha Bujhte Pare.
Now, Anirban Da... Anirban Da, ami tomake bhalobashi. Is that good enough for you? Now, please let me finish what I'm going to say. No, Navika, I want to get to what my good friend Ghanshyam Tiwari actually said, because that's quite important. And I suspect that Ghanshyamji's favorite topic in subject in school was geometry, because he goes on a tangent. बात कुछ और हो रही है. ये किसी और चीज़ पे ले गए. पर पहराल क्योंकि ले गए, उस पे मैं बात करना चाहता हूँ. Ghanshyam ji, आप खुद जानते हैं, you were in power as well as in opposition in UP. The person who is going to talk about development is the incumbent. The opposition talks about the lack of development. अब क्या मोदी बंगाल में already थे पिछले 10 साल? So I want to ask you, do you find two or three things in the last 10 years that TMC has done that reflects lack of development? Or are you going to say that everything is hunky-dory in Bengal? Name just two issues that Mamata Di hasn't done.
Let me respond to that. Right, one that you speak about what the incumbent speaks about and what the opposition does. Who's the opposition? Adityanath. Did you hear what he said on camera to the media people? Dhongi Singh becomes the next generation leaders of this country, and they want to go and challenge a sitting minister. Have you ever heard Mamata Banerjee speak in that language? That is allegedly a fake video. And he was referring to media. Please don't interrupt. He was referring to media. Dhongi Singh will not lead this country to the 21st century.
You know, I want to ask you, Ghanshyam Tiwari, Ghanshyam Tiwari, for all the moral high ground that you take, why don't you also respond to the statement of Mulayam Singh Yadav that was said, ladkon se galtiyan hua karti hain? Why don't you rewind and play out Akhilesh Yadav's various tirades with the media? Have you forgotten Akhilesh Yadav's confrontations with the media? But is that the issue of debate today? As Dr. Anand Ranganathan says, you have a habit of taking tangents and going on to another issue. I want to ask you, is it only Mamata Banerjee who has the freedom of speech? Is it only Akhilesh Yadav who has the freedom of speech? Is it only Rahul Gandhi who has the freedom of speech? The Prime Minister does not enjoy the freedom of speech of what he says, and yet people come throng to see him, hear him, and vote for him again and again, and not for parties that you belong to. But Riju Datta, I want to come back to one single point. And the single point agenda that I'm asking you here is, all this while, when Mamata Banerjee, Sonia Gandhi, H.D. Kumaraswamy, Sitaram Yechuri were on that dais in Bengaluru, in Karnataka, after the Karnataka elections, what did they say? These were all secular parties coming together, and they were standing against a force called the BJP, which was communal in nature. I want to ask you, Riju Datta, plain and simple. When Mamata Banerjee asked for Muslims to come out and vote for Trinamool Congress, is that secular? And if that is secular, then why is Jai Shri Ram communal? Why is it a war cry, as liberals in this country have called it?
I think Navika ji, you are mixing two things together. You know, it is about, let me just give you 10 seconds. See, our government is a pro-people's government. When people are talking about what has happened in Bengal for Muslims or whatever, let me remind you and the viewers now that this is the only state which gives free education, free healthcare, free life insurance, free rations to every citizen of the state. That is irrespective of caste, creed, color or religion. So we believe in people, and it's inclusive.
Oh, yes. You are inclusive. They are inclusive. When Rahul Gandhi says, I am a devotee of Shiva and I believe in truth, he is inclusive. Congress vows to list Lingayat as a separate religion before Karnataka polls, and they are inclusive. Yechuri with a ritual pot at Mahakali festival is absolutely inclusive. DMK vows 1,000 crores for dilapidated temples. That is inclusive. CM Vijayan says Lord Ayappa is with the LDF government. He is very, very inclusive. I want to ask you, Mr. Dr. Nikhil Prasoon, they will label themselves as seculars,
yeah,
and inclusive, but the Prime Minister is exclusive and communal. I want to ask you, who gives them the right to say this?
Well, but before that, when the point that was raised by Mr. Ghanshyam Tiwari, I would like to emphasize that the biggest single casualty in a counterinsurgency operation took place on 6th of April 2010. Well, 76 of our brave hearts were martyred in Dantewada.
And this, okay, Dr. Nikhil Prasoon, there is no competition on the dead bodies of our brains, of our martyrs. Let's not compete on the numbers. Aapke time mein itna hua tha, hamare time mein itna hua tha. It is abominable. I will not allow that to happen on this. Subhrashtraji, I want to ask you, and I want to pass on the question that I asked Nikhil Prasoon. I want to ask you, how can you allow some people to certify themselves as seculars while they certify others as communal?
Navikaji, this is exactly this hypocrisy which has been torn to shreds. This is exactly this hypocrisy which is answered lock, stock and barrel in every elections. This is exactly this hypocrisy which has been put under under a box, and a lid has been placed on it. But unfortunately, the opposition in this country does not yet realize that their narrative of secularism versus communalism, of this ism versus that, is not functional anymore. They'll actually have to start.
Election after election, people have expressed their choice, and people are talking about governments that deliver, leaders that they can believe in and follow. They're not looking at somebody who asks for votes on the basis of whether you are a Muslim, whether you are from a lower caste, whether you are from a higher caste, what they are looking in 2021 India is actually how this country can move forward. Anybody who seems to have a vision to deliver just that, that is the party that people vote for. That is the party that people think are accountable for. And why does one party have to actually go through the Agni Pariksha time and time again? Why don't other parties have to do the same? At least when they give out their politics. Think about it, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you very much to my panelists for joining me on debate number one. Debate number two on vaccine for all or just the age groups that the government has announced so far. That's the debate on the other side.
The News Hour at 9.